Okay students, we are in the commercial cells, and the commercial cells most useful cell in our daily life, that is the cell which is used in our inverters. When in your house electricity is not there, then definitely inverter will take over. So but what is the science behind that inverter, how it works, and what are the chemical reaction taking place? If you know that, then your thinking will be different. Okay, so let's start with the lead acid battery. It is none other than lead acid battery. Okay, so for clarity in the image, for clarity in the concept, for clarity in explanation, I have changed it to the digital board. So I hope everybody will like this video and give their attendance, share it to your friends that you are a viewer, you are a subscriber, you are a part of the Bijchem family, where everything, every day, every part will be a innovation and development. But the development will be there when you are motivating me with the three things: likes, shares, and subscribing others, asking others to subscribe by keeping these are all videos on your status, like WhatsApp status. You can keep it so that unintentionally you are informing to all your family friends, circle friends, classmates that I am a part of the Bijchem family, because of which my chemistry is clear. Okay, so don't think that they are going to be competitor to you, but they are going to remember you for your lifetime because you have informed them about one of the good channel. Okay, so on Bijchem channel I will be providing you guidance of the engineering and medical admissions, and how to write the exam, how to attempt the exams also I am going to inform you. Okay, so let's get started with the lead acid battery. See, this is the diagram of the lead acid battery. Okay, so this is the internal part of the lead acid battery, understood? So let's see the chemical part of the lead acid battery. Let it be any type of battery, they are all electrochemical cell, but the advantage of this lead acid battery is it is rechargeable. So when you have electricity, commercial supply, then it will charge itself. When commercial supply goes off, then it will change its mode, then it will act as a source of energy. That means it can act as two things. What are those two things? It is electrochemical cell, electrolytic cell. So when power goes off, commercial supply goes off, then it will act as electrochemical cell. But when electricity is there, commercial supply is there, that will take the charge. That means it will be electrolytic cell. So suppose at this moment in your home you have inverter, commercial supply is there, so the battery you are connected to inverter is, commercial supply is there, that means it is electrolytic cell. Now all of the sudden complete area is dark, but your house is well lit. Okay, that means your house is because of the electrochemical cell. So chemistry is going to lighten up your world. That is the beauty of the chemistry, understood? You will still be able to watch the match, you will still be able to under the fan, understood? You will be glowing with your visible lights, understood? So these are the advantages of chemistry. Okay, so when power supply goes off, lead acid battery is electrochemical cell. When power supply is there, that time it will be electrolytic cell. Okay, so but common parts are there. So every electrolytic or chemical cell contains how many electrodes? Two electrodes. Okay, so what are the two electrodes? That I am going to tell you. Okay, so here there are two types of electrode. One is called as a spongy lead. What it is called as? Spongy lead. Okay, see, this is the lead plate, spongy lead, understood? And there will be lead oxide. Okay, lead oxide. So two electrodes, one will be PbO2, sometimes it is also called as a lead peroxide. Lead peroxide is one electrode and lead is another electrode, understood? So these are the two electrodes. And sulfuric acid is going to be the electrolyte. Sulfuric acid is going to be the electrolyte. as we require more supply, so you will find more electrochemical cell. This is one electrochemical, second, third, fourth, fifth, like that. Okay, so but all terminals are connected together to give you one output. All terminals are connected together to give you another output, positive and negative terminal. Okay, all positive together, all negative together, you will get the summed up voltage. Is this understood? Constructional, if it is possible, try it. This is the protective casing. Okay, so three things you will understand. What are those three things? What is the electrodes? One electrode is made up of the spongy lead, another is electrode is made up of the lead dioxide or lead peroxide. Third thing is electrolyte is sulfuric acid. All things are connected together to give you better voltage, and they are kept in a protective casing. Okay, so this is about the diagram. If possible, try to draw the diagram, then we will discuss. So that was a real picture, but actually what is chemically, this I am going to explain through this slide. Understood? So here spongy lead. Spongy lead means Pb. This is lead dioxide, PbO2. Okay, so this will act as a positive electrode because it undergoes reduction. PbO2 is already at its highest oxidation state, plus 4. Is it understood? And spongy lead is already at its lowest oxidation state, 0. Understood? So this is going to provide you electron. This is going to provide you electron by undergoing oxidation. So this is the positive plate, negative plate. Sulfuric acid we put here will be dissociated into H positive and SO4 2 negative. Okay, like this cells are placed. Sulfuric acid electrodes connected to the spongy plate, lead plates. These are connected to the lead dioxide. These are lead dioxide plates connected together. These are the lead plates, PV plates. Okay, batteries use a chemical reaction that do work on charge and plate, produce a voltage between their output terminal. This is understood. So try to write down this diagram. Previous diagram was difficult enough and not for the education purpose, it may not be useful, but this is very important. So take few minutes, try to write down. Okay, so as I told you, it can work as a producing voltage, it can consume the voltage. Now let us start with the producing voltage. It is producing voltage means it should act as electrochemical cell. So from this diagram you will understand how it will produce electrons. Understood? So this is possible when you are connecting to the load. Load in the electrical language is just tube light, fan, TV, everything which consumes electricity is called as a load. So this is reaction takes place when you connect the lead acid battery to a load. So in normally you will find a resistance. Okay, so that part also I will be explaining. This is one way of explanation. Spongy lead and lead dioxide. So spongy lead will liberate electrons by undergoing oxidation. So see, before this it is spongy lead. See, before this it is spongy lead. Okay, it react with the sulfuric acid HSO4- to convert into PbSO4. To convert into what? PbSO4 and 2 electrons. This is very very useful. So spongy lead oxidizes from dash to dash. What? 0 to plus 2. Okay, and converts from dash to dash, Pb to PbSO4. So as these electrons are coming out, see, this is the negative terminal of the battery. Electron will go from here. So this is a positive terminal, it will accept. Okay, now when it accepts, see, PbO2 is at a positive oxidation state, okay, plus 4, but after that it is converted into plus 2, PbSO4, reduction. It is all because of the accepting of what? Electrons. Okay, so electrons are accepted from here to here and reduced. So during cathode reaction is PbO2 is converted from plus 4 oxidation state to plus 2. Both ways change in oxidation number is how much? 2 only. But from 0 to plus 2, another is from plus 4 to 0, plus 4 to 2. Okay, now this is cathode, this is anode. What is cathode? PbO2 is cathode, Pb is anode. During the production of voltage, that is electrochemical cell. So if I add both of them, if I add both of them, this is the net reaction. Pb plus PbO2 plus 2HSO4 plus 2HCl, these are all simply you have to add both of the reaction. But these reactions are very important. This diagram is very important. Is that clear? Note down this diagram. So for better clarity, these are again I am during discharging. Either they produce voltage or electrochemical cell or during discharge. Reactions are going to be same. Okay? See here, PbS plus HSO4 plus H2O releases two electrons. That means anode. Okay? Lead will act as anode and change in oxidation number from Pb to PbSO4. Okay? See, one more thing you should remember. In both reactions, sulfuric acid is consumed. Okay? Here also sulfuric acid, here also sulfuric acid. And it is dilute sulfuric acid. That's why HSO4 minus will be there. Understood? And when you are discharging, sulfuric acid is converted into sulfate. Therefore, there will be change in density. There will be what in density? Change in density. Hence, by monitoring the change in density, we can find out how much the life, how much of the voltage left over. Like some display, nowadays everything is displayed. So 2 hours it can run, 1 hour it can run. That is all because of the calculating the density. So sulfuric acid is consumed, there will be change in density. Leftover density can be used for calculating the how much time that charge can be used. Okay? So Pb gives PbSO4, then PbO2 gives PbSO4. Both ways product is same, both ways reactants are HSO4 minus only. Okay? But only thing is 2 electrons are liberated, 2 electrons are consumed. Okay? So number during the calculation, number of electrons will take it as a 2. So this is what about the discharging. When it is charging, it will act as a electrolytic cell. Let's go to the electrolytic cell. Okay, now here it is charging. Now you can see here battery is there. That means our commercial supply. So when here indicates a resistance like that, that means it is an electrochemical cell. When battery is connected, that time it is electrolytic cell. Even with the same battery, suppose its voltage is X voltage, and here X volt it is more than the X voltage, that time this will be electrolytic cell. If this voltage is less than X volt, then this will give it to that time it will be electrochemical cell. So that is the way you understand how inverter understand electricity is there or not. Suppose electricity is there, commercial supply is there. That means the input voltage is more. That time automatically it will act as a charging. That means electrolytic cell. When electrical supply goes off, that time this voltage becomes zero. Then this will start working as electrochemical cell. Is this understood? So this discharge reaction can be reversed by applying voltage from a charging source. This is commercial supply. So everything remains same. Only thing, electron will be changing direction. This is giving the electrons. That time Pb was giving electron. Now this cell will give the electron. Only you have to reverse the reactions. All reactions remain same. Let's see how the reactions are. Okay, the chemical reaction taking place while recharging. While recharging. When a chemical reaction takes place when lead acid battery is charging can be found below. So there it was Pb left side. Now it is PbSO4. Both place you will find PbSO4 only. 2 electron accepted, it will reduce to Pb. 2 electron released, it will change it to the PbO2. Releasing electron changes from Pb plus 2 Pb plus 4. Accepting electron changes from plus 2 to 0. That is the changes taking place during recharging. Just opposite reactions. Okay? Okay, I hope you understood about the lead acid battery. So this is why one of the new way to teach. I hope all of you like this. I think it is better to understand. If you feel the older board method is better, then I will explain on the board only. But there are certain things which I cannot draw. That's why I have used this method. Okay, so many things are to be explained in the theory and question session also. This was only introductory session, like numericals based upon the electrolytic and electrochemical cell, that questions, previous year question, that will practice in our practice session. So don't forget to mark your attendance with a like and share it to your friends about this budding and exploring YouTube channel for the chemistry, that is WhichChem YouTube channel. See you, bye bye.